Tom has attempted using both methods of dealing with the grubber. He should continue to spend sessions working on this so that when the grubber occurs, he can react quickly to get into the best position to deal with the tricky ball.
Nighty.
Okay, so being in that position there as well, because if it bounces a bit more than you think, you can just react to your body to actually catch the ball.
Thank you.
Oh, nasty.
Tom demonstrates some really nice footwork while standing back and is catching most of the balls with his head and hands in line. For the really wide balls Tom takes on the run, you should remember that if it's too far to move his feet to get into a good position, he can use his dive and roll to take the balls, which he does very nicely. Areas for development. For the straighter balls, Tom tends to catch the balls with both his feet together. He should try and keep them at shoulder width apart if he can.
Yeah.
Tom's technique while standing up looks very good and he is consistently taking difficult balls. Tom should be very pleased with the way he's developed over the course. Areas for development. Like standing back, Tom can finish catching the ball with his feet together. Remember, it is very hard to move again quickly from that position. Tom should try not to rush back to the stumps, as this means his head moves off the line of the ball early, which closes his hands and reduces the chance of him taking an edge. But you should remember, do not rush, try and be as smooth and fluent as possible.
Good take, ball, that's our job, catching the ball. Good.
didn't bounce as hard as you got it. Side out, give those hands.